Shalom and Kram Yasha Alei, and now under the sounds of the voice of Supreme Tyler Doc, meaning Supreme Righteous, and welcome to the Truth Show on Universal Indigenous TV 7, where the truth is the only way to square off all unrighteousness. So this is a lesson. You can consider this a plus lesson for the gods and earths, a plus lesson for, you know, the good brother Polite, a plus lesson for Sotnetta, and a plus lesson for anyone that says the Israelites has been spooking God. So understand this. I'm going to break it down, because before anything is in a physical plane, it has to be a thought. And you can't see a thought. You can see it once it's manifest into the physical, but a thought is real, but you can't see it. Just like you can't see the wind. The wind is real, but you can't see it. You understand? So a thought from the mind, that goes back to your lessons, God. But I'm going to make you acknowledge God today in the unseen that you call a mystery God, which is actually the highest form of God that you don't understand because you're operating in this physical plane. But I came from the ninth galaxy as a star seed to give you this right knowledge. So to be born is what, God? Born is to be born both physically as well as mentally. So everything that's actually created eventually has to start from a mental thought, which is actually unseen. It all has its origin in the unseen. So that's the reality, right? But if it's not tangible, you can't comprehend it. So if we have everything's origin in the unseen, how am I being spooky? I'm not spooky. I'm just much on a higher level than most of you. Don't cut the knowledge, God. So to be born is to be, you know, born mentally as well as physically. Mentally means the unseen. So before it's manifest into the physical, it actually has to exist as a thought in the mind, which is unseen. Do you understand? Before it's even pictorial in the mind, it's unseen, which is a thought. Before you do anything, you have to create that thought first, right? Before that thought could actually manifest itself and materialize to anything. Understand that, God? And repeat the lesson. Listen up. So now I'm going to take you into, you know, how God, we're not Yahweh, right? So I'm going to cut all the false belief. We're not Yahweh, but we are God. You understand? So God being perfect, the only thing that he could actually create was himself perfect in his image and likeness. But when you see God in a physical form, that is God in his fallen state. Understand that. Understand that. That's God in a fallen state. If you ever get to the level that I'm on, you would understand that the unseen is the real reality. Like darkness is the true light. See, everybody's looking for the light, but darkness is the true light. Because Yahweh, or what you refer to as Allah, has his origin in darkness. You understand? Because if he was created, or the deity was created, then that wouldn't be God. Because anything that's created is not the highest form of deity, because it came from something else. You understand? So Yahweh, or what you refer to as Allah, Allahim, or the Elohims, meaning the powers, was always in existence. And he willed himself into a physical form. So that's God in a fallen state, so that you could actually comprehend with your little, understanding. But check this out. So let me take you to the book of Genesis. See, you could deal with mathematics, but if you don't understand linguistics, then you're still off. And since this was actually written in the Ibrit, we're going to look at the Ibrit. And I want you to pay particular attention to what I have highlighted there. Adam. Adam. So when you really do the research on Adam and you look up, you know, in that lexicon or Strong's, Adam, now the typical Bible lists Adam just simply as a man. Now in cipher, God, la'ah, that is off. Lo, that is a mistranslation in your English Bibles. This is why you got to be able to understand the Ibrit. Adam simply means a human being. It's not gender specific. It's actually referring to humanity or humankind. So what I want you to do now is look up Strong's H120, because everything I say is right and exact. And I'm going to show and prove that God in the beginning was not gender specific. Understand that. Until he was actually in his fallen state. So now let's get the knowledge. These are the generations of the heaven and the earth when they was created in the day of the Lord Yahweh made earth and heaven. No shrub of the fields was yet in the earth, and no herb of the field had yet sprung up. For the Lord Yahweh had not caused it to rain upon the earth, and there was no man, Adam. See, this Bible, the English translation is using the word man. Now in cipher, God, that is a mistranslation. That the term that should be there is mankind or humanity. There was no humanity or no mankind, meaning man or woman, to till the ground. Look it up yourself. But there went up a mist from the earth and watered the whole face of the ground. The Lord Yahweh formed Adam of the dust of the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and Adam became a living soul. So the way that the English Bibles are interpreting this, they're automatically putting man there, but Adam does not have a gender specific. Understand that. It's referring to humanity. And I'm going to show you when it gets to male and female, it's not being gender specific right now. You understand? So this is still, we're still doing on a higher level, which is spiritual. You understand? He had not created an Adam. So now we see, even up into the verse 7 right here, Genesis 2 and 7, the Lord Yahweh formed man out of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. You see, the English translations are translating this to be man, but it really shouldn't say man. It should say Adam, which means humanity or mankind. It is not gender specific. Again, go back and look it up in Strong's. You can see what I'm talking about. Look at Strong's H120 to show and prove everything that I'm saying is right and exact. So at this point, even when he formed humanity out of the dust of the earth, is not gender specific by hand. It is not male or female. Understand that, King. Understand that. I hope you can see this. I pray that you can see this, because I'm advocating this. This is why linguistics is essentially important, and not just mathematics. You understand? You got to know them both. So now I'm going to take you to verse 8, and we're going to continue on. So I'm going to add verse 8 in here. And, you know, the Lord Yahweh planted a garden eastward in Eden, and there he put the man whom he formed. So again, you see the English translation has this interpreted as the man, but the Hebrew word is still Adam, which means humanity or mankind, not gender specific. Do you understand? Don't get mad, just get your mind right. So then we're going to jump down to verse 15, where it's important. And the Lord Yahweh took the man and put him into the Garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. Still using that Hebrew word, Adam. It's still not referring to a gender specific. And the Lord Yahweh commanded the man, Adam, meaning humanity, saying, of every tree of the garden thou mayest eat freely. Verse 17. But of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, thou shalt not eat of it, for the day that thou shalt eat of it, thou shalt surely die. And the Lord Yahweh said, it is not good that the man be alone. Now, okay, what do we have here now? What do we have here now? Are we dealing with the same phrase? Ken, yes, we are. So it's still using the Hebrew word Adam, which actually means humanity, not male, not female. This is not specifically gender oriented, so that you can understand. So when you read Genesis 2 and 18, it says the Lord Yahweh said that it is not good that Adam shall be alone. I will make the English translation is using the word him here, right? When we look it up in the Ibrit, that word that they're using for him is Nachat, Strong's 5048, which means an opposite, a counterpart, or a mate. But the English, the translators, they're throwing the word him like that. You see what I'm saying? This has all of you people that doesn't study linguistics going way off. So we're still not dealing with a gender specific right here. So the spirit, this Ruah, and you know, this humanity that the Most High had actually created is not referred to as a gender specific, you know, male or female right here. Understand that, God. Understand that, kid. Understand that. And I don't dare anyone to disprove this because I'm giving it to you in the Ibrit, in the Hebrew. So now let's continue on. We're going to go ahead and we're going to move on along to the 19th verse right here. And we're going to show and prove, man. We're going to show and prove, and you're going to get the right understanding. You can lack it, understand it, believe it or not. So right now, up until this point, the Most High, when you read it in the Ibrit, in the Torah, he's not dealing with a specific gender, male or female. Understand that. Now, I know this is going to hurt a lot of people's feelings, but I got to tell the truth because that's what the Most High sent me here to tell you the truth. Starseed, right? So, in the beginning, humanity essentially really doesn't have a gender specific. Understand that. Understand that. In order for, you know, the Most High to actually create a female, he has to have that aspect from himself. You understand? To manifest a part of himself. Understand that. So the first form of God was actually in that state, no gender. Now we're going to jump to verse 22 and get more understanding here, right? We're going to get some more understanding in my head. So we're going to go ahead and jump to verse 22 where it starts using these phrases again. And the rib, which the Lord Yahweh had taken from Ha-Adam, is still using that. From humanity, mankind. Oh, what happened? Let's see what happened here. From Ha-Adam made he a Isha. Isha. So now this is the first time he starts to get gender specific. Isha. Isha, when you look it up in Strong's H802, Isha, this is the first form in feminine. In feminality, that's actually used in the scriptures. You understand? Look it up for yourself. Don't believe me. Strong's H802, this is the first time the female gender is actually used into the scriptures. And then brought her to how? Adam. The man. This is what they are actually interpreting as the man. And Adam, what they're calling the man, said, "This is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. And she shall be called Isha because why? Because she was taken out of what? She was taken out of the man. She was taken out of man. She was taken out of Ish. You understand? She was. I need you to pay specific attention up into the book of Genesis 2 and 24 for which you guys refer to as man, that the translators is translating it as man, but it's still Adam, which actually means mankind, humanity, not gender specific. And they start using the woman for Ish at the Eve was actually created, but a magnificent thing occurs in Genesis 2 and 24. It says, therefore shall a Ish mean a man. Now it's using a male gender specific. It's using a male gender specific. Shall a man. It's no longer saying humanity or mankind. So how many of you catch that? Look it up for yourself. Strong's H376. Shall a man, which is actually an individual male person, is no longer talking about humanity. And this is what most people that don't get linguistics, don't understand linguistics, you missed the mark, and you clearly don't understand scriptures, which is why the Most High is raising up a king like myself, Tyler Doc, not to be boastful or anything. So now we see the creation of Ish and Isha, right? The male and the female, gender specific. So up until this point, Adam was never gender specific. Until there was actually, the male and the female. When he created the woman, then he decided to make them, you know, male and female. Then suddenly, Adam actually took on the male gender of male, and Eve took on the gender of female, right? Ish and Isha, right? These are fallen states of God. Because when God was just Adam, it was pure. They was walking in righteousness. But after they became Ish, male, and female, it was the Isha, the female, that made a covenant with Satan, that made a covenant with the devil. You understand? The woman that came out of God brought sin into the world. Do you understand? I hope that you can receive this. To those of you that can actually receive it. I mean, some of you won't be able to receive this. And I could understand that. Because this requires a higher level of thinking. If you're on the physical plane, you're not going to get this. Most of you gods may not get this. Because this is outside of your realm. Because if it's not tangible to you, you can't seem to grasp it. You know what I mean? You understand? But the physical and the darkness is the real light. So that you could understand.